the revised syllabus of CBSE, but you should remember that. So there is going to be in the PUC, they have not yet given the revised syllabus. So as of CBSE, there is a revised syllabus, but in our NEET integrated classes, we are doing the complete syllabus part of it because we have not yet received the revised NEET syllabus also. See, for NEET syllabus, it might be there. So it is better that we are going through it. So at least even if it doesn't get incorporated, we'll be giving marks for it. For the assignment, whatever topics we have done, we can consider it as assignment part of it and assign the marks later on in the CBSE classes. That is the thing. Around 6 to 7 of you are from CBSE stream. Remaining are from state syllabus. You have joined up for the PU, but you are all into integrated, isn't it? So one thing that you have to remember is in the PU part of it, they have not yet given the reduction in the syllabus. So let us study this morphology and anatomy of cockroach, the type study of cockroach. See, your NCERT books gives three things: type study of cockroach, type study of earthworm, and type study of frog. So but those two are not included for study. So type study of cockroach will be studying about, where in detail we'll be studying the external morphology of cockroach, then we'll be studying the digestive system, circulatory system, respiratory system, and reproductive system. If you look into the slide itself, all of these are given here. So what we might be studying about. So diagram part of point of view, the cockroach is very important, especially the digestive system of cockroach, mouth parts of cockroach, or the male reproductive system of cockroach, or female reproductive system of cockroach. So you should be aware about these diagrams that you are expected to practice and label them. Neat label diagram you should be drawing during the examination in case they ask for 5 mark questions or a 3 marks question. You should be prepared for it. See, the type study of cockroach we are going to do. Before we go into it, you should remember that cockroach is belonging to the phylum Arthropoda. They have jointed limbs or jointed legs, you can notice. So three pairs of legs are there, and since they are insects, the outer part of their body is made up of chitin. Exoskeleton is made up of chitin. So they have excretory structures in the form of Malpighian tubules. So all this you have to remember about in case of cockroach. So they have trachea, tracheal system for respiration. So they have open type of circulatory system. They do not pour their the blood into the vessels or veins. So they have an open type of circulatory system wherein the fluids are directly filled into the cavity. So all these points you have to remember about, since they belong to this Arthropoda and class Insecta. They have three pairs of legs. So they are arising from the prothorax, mesothorax, and metathorax. So body is divisible, and you can distinguish the insect's body into the head, the thorax, and the abdominal region. Okay, so that is what you have to remember about a few points, initial points from our knowledge of phylum Arthropoda. So cockroach, the scientific name is Periplaneta americana. Periplaneta americana. So it is almost seen everywhere, distributed on the planet, almost omnipresent. Okay. So the Periplaneta americana, it belongs to the phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta. Genus is Periplaneta americana. Maybe some of you find it very gross seeing the cockroach and the nature of it. See, they are nocturnal. So they are active during nighttime. Omnivorous, that is, they can feed on anything almost. It can be the any type of food. They can have the herbivore or the carnivore type of food. So they are omnivores. They live in damp places, moist places. So their color, if you look into, they are brown or black in color. They are bright yellow, red, and green colored cockroaches that are seen in tropical regions. See, you find cockroaches of this nature, red and green colored cockroaches in tropical regions, you can notice. So they are nearly 1/4 inch to 3 inches in size. Okay, so here you can notice this cockroach and its young ones. So the young ones, they are of larger in number. Okay, so from a single egg, you can get 16 nymphs or 16 young ones would be formed. Okay, from a single egg of cockroach. So you should know about it. So this particular carapace structure, you can notice almost eye-like structures. They are not eye, they are just to scare the predators off. Okay, so this is the basic description about the cockroach, where they are found and what is its nature of it. So they are nocturnal animals, they are omnivorous. They live in damp and moist places. So in this below the sink and other regions, you can find them. They are a big pest because you find that any amount of the spraying using the insect repellent, we are not able to eradicate them. Reason is each egg, it can produce 16 nymphs, okay? Not one nymph, 16 young ones, we are calling them as nymph. So 16 young ones, they are able to produce from one egg. So you can just understand their multiplication rates. Okay, the color of the cockroach is brown or black in color. They are bright yellow, red and green colored in the tropical regions. So their size varies from 1/4 inch to 3 inches in size. The adults are about 34 to 53 mm long, millimeter long. Body is covered by a hard brown chitinous exoskeleton. So they are covered by hard brown chitinous exoskeleton. So you can see the segmentation also. So they are covered by this hard brown chitinous structures, exoskeleton that you can notice. So above these are the wings. So when I come to the parts of cockroach again, I'll be, the morphology will be describing about, okay. So in each and every segment of the cockroach, see, this is the ventral view, this is the dorsal view. So they have this antennae, the head region is there, okay. Then they have three pairs of legs. The three pairs of leg arise from, one pair arises from prothorax, another pair arises from mesothorax. From the thoracic region, they are arising. And this last pair arises from the metathorax. So they have this hardened plates called sclerites. So the sclerites consists of turgites. See, the turgites are the dorsal region, we call them as turgites. And the ventral region, we call this as turnites. So the dorsal region, we can find the turgites, and the ventral regions, you find the sternites. Okay, they are joined together, the turgites and the sternites, they are joined to each other by a thin and flexible articular membrane, or we also call it as arthroidal membrane. So the body of cockroach has three regions, the head region. So you can notice here in the ventral view, the head region. So they have a compound eye. So the antenna is noticed. Mouth parts are also there, where they have upper lip, lower lip. Even they have tongue, mandibles, maxilla, you can notice. So the body has three regions in case of cockroach, the head, thorax, and abdomen. So the sternites, dorsal sternites, and ventral turgites, they are fused by a thin and flexible articular membrane, which we call it as arthroidal membrane. Okay, the body is divided into three zones: head, thorax, and abdomen. So head region, triangular head is formed by six fused segments. Okay, six of the segments are fused to form the triangular head. Six segments, remember about it. So the cephalization is high in case of cockroach. It shows great mobility in all directions due to flexible neck. It has a flexible neck and it can move its neck towards all the direction. So the head bears a pair of thread-like antenna. So they have this thread-like antenna, what you might call mesiae of this cockroach. It's not the mustache of cockroach, it is the antenna, the filiform antenna. So head bears a pair of thread-like antenna, a pair of compound eyes. You can see this eyes, which is made up of ommatidia, so individual units, so compound eyes, and biting and chewing type of mouth parts. So we'll discuss about that when we come to the mouth parts of cockroach. So the dorsal view, you can notice that they have a filiform antenna, compound eye. This is the head region, and the scary region where they have almost eye-like dots, it is the pronotum. Then you can notice the mesothorax, prothorax, metathorax. So they are all going to give rise to the three pairs of limbs. So the jointed legs, you can notice that. So a pair of legs are mesothoraic legs, metathoracic legs. The abdominal regions, you can notice. So wings are there. So tegmina and hind wings, you can notice, apart from the major wing, which overlaps completely them. So there is a tegmina wing and the hind wing. Okay. Now the morphology, the head part, the trophy or mouth parts of cockroach, we call it as trophy. See, they have a labrum, which is the upper lip. So we used to have a dissection in our PU where we had to remove this mouth parts and exhibit it on the slide. Okay, but for you, you do not have those dissection activities much. But I remember at my PU level, we were all we had to get cockroaches from our homes, and we had to put it in a soap water, get them killed, and then get those cockroach and remove this mouth parts and focus it on the slide. Okay, we were doing that and observing it under dissection microscope. Nowadays, you don't have it probably in your labs. They might demonstrate it. That might happen. So the labrum is the upper lip and labium is the lower lip. They have this tongue, which we call it as hypopharynx. See, even the cockroaches have all these things, labrum, upper lip and lower lip. Then they have hypopharynx. And you have a pair of mandibles, you can see in case of this cockroach mouth parts. They help in grinding of the food that they feed. Then they have this maxilla. Okay, so the maxilla will be having palps. So this is what you have to remember about. So they have this compound eye. Here you can see the lateral view of the mouth parts. So they have the mandible, labrum, labium, maxilla is there. So the hypopharynx is nothing but the tongue. So the mouth part of it, you can notice here. So what are they made up of? A labrum or upper lip, a labium or lower lip. Then they have two mandibles, which are helping in the grinding of the food, whatever they are going to consume. Then they have two maxillae. Okay. Then they have hypopharynx, which is also called as tongue. So this hypopharynx further extends into the esophagus of the digestive system of cockroach. So if they ask you trophy of cockroach, these diagrams you have to draw. So this is important. Not this one, these diagrams, the mouth parts of cockroach, you should be drawing it. Or they might ask you in the NEET or CET, they might just ask you to label it. So the lower lip has more of palps, okay, extensions. The upper lip doesn't have it. Upper lip is the labrum, lower lip is labium, okay. Then they have a pair of mandibles, a pair of maxilla, hypopharynx, or we also call it as tongue. So that you should be remembering about. The thorax region, next when we go into it. So it has three parts, the prothorax, mesothorax, and metathorax. So the head is connected to thorax by a neck. Short extension of the prothorax itself is the neck. Each thoracic segment, that is prothorax, bears a pair of legs. We call it as prothoracic legs. Mesothorax having a pair of legs, we call it as mesothoracic leg. Metathorax having a pair of legs, metathoracic legs. So each thoracic segment bears a pair of walking legs. So they are jointed limbs. Okay. And you can, in this morphology part of the diagram of it, the ventral view, you can see the compound eye, head, antenna, all these regions. Then the wings are there. Then forewing, the tegmina. Okay, So the metathorax region, you can also see once you remove these wings and other things, you can notice this metathorax and mesothorax is noticeable. Okay, but the pronotum will be covering the prothorax. So the anal style and the anal sulcus. So you can notice in the cockroach. So the thoracic region, they also have two pairs of wings. So the dorsal view, if you look into, or the dorsal ventral view, you can notice the pair of the three pairs of legs you can notice. In the dorsal region, you can notice these wings, four wings and hind wings. Four wings are also two in number. Hind wings are also two in number. So the four wings arises from the mesothoracic or tegmina region. They are opaque, dark, and leathery. See, you can notice here the four wings. They are opaque, dark, and leathery, and cover the hind wings. So the hind wings are not visible, okay, when at rest. So the hind wings, they are metathoracic in origin. So the four wings were mesothoracic. The hind wings were metathoracic in origin. They are transparent, membranous, and they are used in flight. So the tegmina, so they are transparent, membranous, and they are used in flight. So this is the hind wings that you can notice from the dorsal end. The abdomen, if you look into cockroach, so we are still discussing the morphology of cockroach. It consists of 10 segments. Okay, in females, the seventh boat shaped, that is the eighth and ninth sterna, form a brood or genital pouch. So in female, you can see that seventh, eighth boat shaped, it is the seventh segment. Eighth and ninth sterna, they form a brood or genital pouch. So eighth and ninth, you can see the brood or genital pouch. So it contains, so what do this genital pouch, they contain female gonophore, spermatheca spores, and collateral glands. So they contain female gonopore, spermatheca pores, and collateral glands. See, you did not have to draw these diagrams. These are only for understanding. So the mouth parts of cockroach you have to practice. So these things, what I am displaying here, it is only for the understanding of these. So the in females, the seventh is boat shaped to show that if these diagrams are there. So seventh is boat shaped, eighth and ninth sterna, they form a brood or genital pouch. So it contains the female, so you can notice here, it contains the female gonophore, spermatheca pores, and collateral glands. Okay, so the abdomen region consists of 10 segments. In females, the seventh is boat shape, eighth and ninth, the sterna, they are going to fuse to form a brood or genital pouch. These contains the female gonophore, spermatheca pores, and collateral glands. So FSC, you can remember it as. In males, the genital pouch lies at the hind end of abdomen, bounded dorsally by 9th and 10th. So it is 7th and other things are not included here. 9th and 10th terga, and ventrally by 9th sternum. So they form a pouch, genital pouch they are going to form. 9th and 10th terga, and ventrally by 9th sternum. So it consists of, what does this genital pouch consist of? Dorsal anus, ventral male genital pore or gonophore, and gonapophysis. So dorsal anus, ventral male genital pore, which we call it as gonophore, and gonapophysis. So that is what the genital pouch, male genital pouch consists of. So in the abdomen region, in both sexes, 10th segment, they bear a pair of jointed anal cerci. So anal cercus is singular, anal cerci is plural. So they have a, both of them will be having, male and female will have this anal cerci, but anal style is present only in males. So style is present only in males, not that style, the anal style. So males bear a pair of short, thread-like anal styles. So that anal style is absent in case of female. But ANL Sarkai is present in both the males and female. You find this ANL Sarkai, but ANL style is present only in case of males. So style is present only in case of males. So I'm talking about anal style. So, but to remember, you can just remember males have style in case of cockroach. That is how you can remember it. Females, they do not have this anal style. So now the differences between male and female cockroach. So sometimes for 2 marks, they might ask you. So male is larger in size. Female is smaller in size. The wings extend beyond the tip of the abdomen. You can notice that it is beyond the abdomen, the wings extend in case of male. Whereas in female, they do not extend beyond the tip of the abdomen. So they have a narrow abdomen in case of males, whereas in females, it is a broad abdomen. You can notice that they have a broad abdomen because they have to lay eggs. So that is the reason they have a broader abdomen, whereas in case of males, it is narrow abdomen. The anal styles are present, okay? So anal style is absent. So anal style is present in case of male, style is absent in case of female. So brood pouch is absent, genital pouch is there, but brood pouch is absent in case of males. So brood pouch is present in case of female. So that is the difference between male and female cockroach. So I think physically, when you look into them, you should be able to differentiate between them. So the wings, if they are extending beyond the tip of the abdomen, so that you notice only in case of males. In females, they do not extend beyond the tip of the abdomen. So males are larger in size, females are smaller in size. So males have a narrow abdomen, females have a broader abdomen. Anal styles are present in case of, style is present in case of male. So anal style is absent in case of female. So brood pouch is absent in case of male. So brood pouch is present in case of female.
Sir,
okay. So I think this would be sufficient for today's discussion.
Sir?
Okay. Yeah, please tell me.